Why is it so important for girls to have a strong man in their lives?
Well, one of the reasons is that fathers play a very important role. Again, as you stated, mothers usually are there, but you need that strong father and role model figure. A lot of young ladies are suffering with low self-esteem. Mm. A lot of them, you know, have inabilities to make and build relationships.
So they'll accept affection from anyone, probably.
From anyone, mm-hmm. Yes. They'll either enter into relationships at an earlier age. Usually, you know, we would think about most girls entering into relationships at age 18 or mm-hmm. maybe 16. Mm-hmm. But now you're having young girls that are entering into serious relationships or what they consider serious relationships.
Intimate relationships.
Yes.
So what do we do, gentlemen, to make sure that bond is there, that we improve the bond, that closeness between father and daughter?
Making sure that communication piece is there. That's the most important. You have to make sure that the father is there and he is taking responsibility of, you know, the household. Even if they're in a relationship, the parents are in a relationship and they're, you know, have separated or somewhat,
right.
That father needs to have some type of communication mm-hmm. with that family, and particularly the daughters.
I suppose this is the way that girls know how to pick a man, right? Know what kind of man to pick, right? Based on the man who's been in their lives, their whole life?
Yes, ma'am, I would agree with that. As a father to a 17-year-old daughter myself, I find that the father is the model of masculinity. Mm. He's the model of what manhood should be about, what manhood should look like, but most importantly, the way that a man should interact with a woman.
Mm-hmm.
What made you want to write your book?
To be honest, the book was inspired by my wife. We were holding weekly Bible class sessions in my home, and my wife felt that some of the information that I had been sharing with my children needed to go down on paper. So I started writing, and a month passed, and 2 months passed, and 5 months later, I was still writing, and then the next thing you know, we have this book, which is inspiring fathers to be more actively involved in the life of the daughter.
Mm-hmm. How do you help the fathers if the mother of the child, let's say in a separation situation, a divorce situation, doesn't want to foster that relationship?
Well, again, bringing in someone on the outside, whether that's professional counseling, someone from the family, or another outside family member, just to make sure, again, the communication is the most important part. You have to have that communication piece. A lot of times, young girls, they long for that, to have that, you know, understanding from their father or a male figure. Mm-hmm. And who else to do that except for the father?
Yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah.
How early in life should this start, though?
I believe that it should start immediately. Immediately. My daughter was able to really understand me as a father somewhere around the age of maybe 2 or 3. Mm-hmm. So as soon as the child makes entrance into the world, the father should be present. And once the child has an understanding of who the father is and she can understand and receive instruction from him, I believe it should start as soon as possible. Mm-hmm.
Do you think women don't understand the importance of the father in that relationship and, you know, may discount it themselves?
Yes, when you look at most communities, a lot of them are headed by single females or mothers. So a lot of times they feel, well, the father is not needed. If mm-hmm. I can do it myself, why do I need the father?
Right.
You know, and when they see other women in the same predicament and situation, it's kind of like, well, there's no need for it.
Right, it's normal.
It's normal.
Right.
Yeah, and that's one of the biggest issues, that we have made it a normal thing just to have single families mm. or single parent homes. Yeah. It's very important to have both parents.
Because obviously this does not just affect the family. This impacts a community. This impacts society, does it not?
Yes, it does. I believe that there's a part of every child that is inextricably connected to its father. There's a longing for the father. Even in my own life personally, I did not meet my father until I was about 20 years old. Mm-hmm. And I always longed to know about him and to meet him and to know his life story. So I think that what we really need to do is encourage women to understand that it's going to be difficult to raise a family without the father, because there's a part of that child that is longing for that father's approval.
All right.